2015 was the year we saw Pluto and found water on Mars. In 2016, we're going to learn just how the planets were made. Hello everyone and Happy New Year! Amy with you on DNews today, looking ahead at what to expect in space this year. There's a lot going on. The European Space Agency's ExoMars Rover will land on Mars, OSIRIS-REx will launch towards an asteroid, and Rosetta will smash into Comet 67P. But two upcoming missions really stand out to me. One is called InSight.
Oh my gosh, you guys, Amy shot this video before leaving for the holidays, and on December 22nd, NASA postponed the InSight mission she was going to talk about until like 2018. So I'm subbing in really quick with a mission that didn't make the cut before. JAXA, the Japanese space agency, is launching an X-ray astronomy telescope, Astro H, in February of next year. X-rays are produced when cosmic matter is heated to millions of degrees. We physically cannot observe those emissions with surface telescopes because to X-rays, the Earth's atmosphere is opaque. It can't go through them. By looking at them from space, we can pick up tons of data that's impossible to gather here on Earth. To pick up as much as possible even, the satellite has four sensor systems, allowing it to measure hard and soft X-rays, gamma rays, and perform X-ray spectroscopy. Once launched from Japan, the Astro H will open up windows into the distribution of dark matter in the galaxies and the large-scale structure of the universe. Very cool. Okay, back to Amy. Sorry about InSight.
Another mission this year is going to look into the solar system's formation as a whole by looking at Jupiter. NASA's Juno spacecraft will arrive at the Jovian system on July 5th. And like another Mars mission, it might seem like we know plenty about the largest planet. We've been to Jupiter a lot, but most of those missions have been flybys on the way to other destinations. The Pioneer probes, the Voyager probes, New Horizons, Cassini, and Ulysses all flew past Jupiter without stopping. Galileo went into orbit around the gas giant from 1995 to 2003, and we haven't had anything in orbit since. We're long overdue for a dedicated Jupiter mission, particularly one that will measure something we don't know anything about, the amount of water in Jupiter's atmosphere. This seems really esoteric, but it's actually going to help scientists with the major question of which planetary formation theory is correct, or it'll tell us if we need an entirely new theory, just by telling us where the water on Earth came from. If Juno finds that there is little water in Jupiter's atmosphere, scientists will be able to conclude that icy bodies like asteroids from the distant Kuiper Belt brought water as ice to the rocky inner planets. And because Jupiter is our best example of a giant planet, knowing more about its formation will help us understand the planets we see around other stars. There are so many exciting missions going on right now, but if you're like me and you have a little bit of a soft spot for the missions of yesteryear, like NASA's 1960s plan to send astronauts to Venus, come dive into space history with me on my own channel, Vintage Space. Instead of jettisoning the spent S4B upper stage, the crew would actually use it. Stored inside the environmental module would be everything the crew would need to turn the spent S4B stage into a habitat module. We'll have a link to that video in the description. What missions are you guys looking forward to this year? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.